So here I am in my office. I wanted to kind of talk to you guys about the latest Happy Planner release for their stickers and their planners for 2020-2021. Now, this video is slightly different because I don't have a flip through of all of the Happy Planner products. I'm not part of the Happy Planner squad or one of the former Happy Planner squadruits is what they call them. So I don't have all of the products to flip through for you. So this is not that type of video. And also I don't have the Joann's or Hobby Lobby near me so that I can buy all of this stuff. So really this video is just my thoughts on the latest release and how to choose what to buy and how not to suffer FOMO, fear of missing out. So if you guys want to join me for this video, go ahead. But if this is not what you're looking for, sorry. Okay. So the Happy Planner have done an amazing, amazing job once again of creating stickers to suit and meet every style of planner out there, because we all know we all have such different styles. And the new planners coming out for 2020-2021, the 18-month planners, are beautiful, and they have some neutral ones, which are fantastic. Now, how do you choose? How do you choose which ones to buy? Well, firstly, with planners, I already did a video a few months ago about how to choose your planners, and I will link it down below. But really, when it comes to the planners, you have to think about three things: your size, layout, and the color of it. So choose your size, whether it's big, mini, classic. Oh my God, I forgot them. Big, mini, classic, or even skinny, mini, skinny, classic. Think of the layout, whether you want horizontal, vertical, dashboard, lined, vertical, horizontal. And then you got to think about the color of the planner, the color of the dividers, the colors that are actually on the pages. So those are three things that you need to think about when choosing a planner. Now, when it comes to the stickers, for me, there's three things that I really think about when it comes to choosing a sticker. Firstly, I actually look at its availability. And the way that you can actually check the availability now, which is great, is on the Happy Planner website. You can actually click on the new release sticker books, and it will show you in the description whether or not it's going to be released in just the Happy Planner website and Michael's, Hobby Lobby, or Joann's, which I think is fantastic that the Happy Planner have done that. So we all know ahead of time where to find these stickers, and we're not hunting around everywhere. So for me, availability is actually such an important thing because I live in Canada. Now, we only have Michael's here. We don't have Joann's or Hobby Lobby. And shipping from the Happy Planner website is $27. So it really is quite expensive. So my options really are what is available in Michael's. So that's the first thing I look at, is availability. Secondly, once I figured out what is available, I also look at YouTube video flip-throughs. There's a lot of planner babes out there who do have flip-throughs of all the sticker books right now. Calavaplan is great. Erica Canant has some flip-throughs. I know According to Ally may have some. Happy to Plan has some as well. So look out there for Happy Planner flip-throughs, and there's a lot of them that will provide flip-throughs of the sticker books. So that's also how I choose what I want, is looking through those flip-throughs and seeing what it is that are the styles speaking to me, are the actual stickers in there that I'd actually use. So for example, I love boxes, I love quotes, and I love decor. But when it comes to like the actual core, you know, the full boxes that fit in the full boxes of a classic planner, I don't use those as often. So a book filled with that wouldn't necessarily speak to me, because I know that that's not something I normally decorate with. It's actually something very difficult for me to decorate with. But if it's a sticker book that has a lot of decor, like Detailed Florals is a good example. Detailed Florals is one of my new favorites because it has everything that I like in there. It's got the quarter boxes, some decorative boxes, a lot of functional boxes. It's got a lot of decor. So really, for me, that's a great sticker book. Now, once I've seen the YouTube flip throughs, looked at what's available, I start to make my list of what it is that I really, really want, and then kind of pare it down, because some of these things may not necessarily be available for me. Like there's one sticker book, I think it's the Year to Shine, sticker book I really, really want. But unfortunately it's only available in Joann's or from the Happy Planner website. And to me, it's not worth $27 to ship one sticker book. So pare it down pretty well. So once I've chosen the ones that I think are coming or that I know are coming to Michael's, then I look through the flip throughs to see if there are sticker books that I actually really want. And then I make my list of that. And then when I actually get to Michael's and I'm able to actually flip through these stickers, then I can really decide whether or not these are stickers that I want to use. So my process has actually really worked for me. It's helped save me a lot of money anyway, because I haven't purchased a ton of sticker books. For me, like, my sticker book collection is back here. It's just these two holders. I don't even know, like, I don't think it's even half of what the Happy Planner have released. And I have been with the Happy Planner, planning with the Happy Planner and their sticker books since January of 2017, so 3 years. So back then they only had, I think, less than maybe 10 sticker books out at that time, and I didn't even have them all. Whereas now they're releasing that many every season, so it's fantastic, the selection. But I've learned, really, my process that works for me is what I've just outlined to you, is looking at the flip throughs, looking at where it's available, and then really, once I get into the store, really looking at the, touching the stickers, and making really sure that you really, really want it, and you really have to ask yourself. And this actually leads me to my next point, is how not to suffer from fear of missing out. You do not need all the planners and all the stickers, and it can be really overwhelming if you do buy all of them. One, on your budget, but two, just having all the stuff and being like, I don't know how to use any of it. I've seen a lot of planners, new planners especially, who buy everything, but because they don't know their style yet, they get overwhelmed with all the stuff, and then like a month or two later, they're selling all of it because it's just become overwhelming. So we don't want you guys to go through that. So we want you to buy sticker books and use them intentionally. And what I mean by that is, choose stickers that you really love and see yourself using. Make a budget for yourself so you don't go too crazy. And then when you also make a budget, you're very aware of what it is that you will say yes and no to. And then lastly, use up your current stash and find the joy in your old sticker books. So do a Marie Kondo and look through your old sticker books. If those sticker books do not give you any joy, de-stash. And actually, I do that every season. I actually de-stash a few sticker books once I know that there's new sticker books coming in. So de-stash. And like a lot of you have said to me, there are planners out there who don't mind a half-used sticker book. So I actually have somebody local that I've been selling a lot of my used sticker books to, and she completely appreciates it. So I will probably be de-stashing some more to her within the next little while here. So in conclusion, basically, when it comes to choosing your stickers, make a budget, do your research, and find the things that you really love and will use. And I'm not going to say really need, because we don't really need stickers, but really buy the things that you love and will use on a day-to-day basis. Be intentional in your purchases. Be really intentional in your purchases. And then lastly, enjoy the process. Don't get overwhelmed. Buying stickers shouldn't be stressful. It should be fun, and it should be something exciting for you. All right, but that is it for me. Thank you guys for watching this quick video on my thoughts on the Happy Planner release. Well, at the end, it really wasn't a video on the thoughts on the Happy Planner release, because I don't actually have it, so I can't give you my actual opinion. I'm giving you my opinion on how to buy smart, how to buy what you really love and what you will use, and how not to get overwhelmed. All right, again, that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, please leave me a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.